Okay, so you've been asked to find the voltage across three resistors that are in series in this circuit here, and the current that's going through all three of those resistors. So we have a 5-volt voltage source in this problem, in the circuit. We have R1, we're going to be looking for the voltage across R1, R2, the voltage across R2, and R3, the voltage across R3. The three resistor values are listed up here. We have 1500 for resistor number one, 4700 for resistor number two, and 1000 for resistor number three. All right, so the easiest thing to do of them all first is to find a total current that's actually going through the three resistors. In order to find a total current that's going through the three resistors here, what we can do is we can use Ohm's law. Remember that Ohm's law says that V is equal to IR. Or we can use that for Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. The voltage here, since we're looking for the total current, we can say the total current and the total resistance, and then for total voltage, and we can take that total voltage divided by the total resistance, and that will give us our total current when we manipulate that equation. All right, so first of all, we know what our voltage is, we don't know what our total resistance is, so let's go ahead and find the total resistance of our circuit. In order to find the total resistance of our circuit, what we're going to do is we're going to find the total resistance of series resistors. And remember, for total resistance of series resistors, we just simply add them together, so that's R1 plus R2 plus R3, and that will give us our series total resistance for our series resistors. So that's equal to 1500 plus 4700 plus 1000, right? So go ahead and add those up together. 700 plus 1000. And we end up with a total resistance then of 7200 ohms. All right, for our circuit here. So we take that total resistance then, and we're going to use that to divide the total voltage, which was 5 volts. And that's 7200. Oops. ohms, and that's going to give us our total current. And that total current then is going to be 5 volts divided by the 7200. And then we have to take, well, we're not actually going to do that. I made a mistake there. Okay, so that's going to be equal to 6.94. times 10 to the minus 6.94, oops, I missed that, 9 94 let's go 944 times 10 to the minus 4th, all right, and this is going to be in amps, so that's our total current. So now to find the value of the total, the voltage across each of our resistors here, resistor 1, resistor 2, resistor 3, we may use Ohm's law again. So what we're going to have then is the value of resistor 1, which is 1500, or let me write the equation out first just to remind you. So again, V is equal to IR, so V1 is equal to I total, because that's a current that's going through R1, times R1, okay, and that's going to give us our voltage for resistor number one across resistor number one, and so that's 6.9444 times 10 to the minus 4th amps, and that's going to be times the 1500 that we have, 1500 ohms, and that tells us then that V1 6.944 times 10 raised to the negative fourth times 1500. That gives us a a voltage of 1.042 volts for the voltage across number one. In order to find a voltage across number two, that's going to be voltage across number two is going to be equal to that current that's going through number two, which is the total current. Remember, it's a series circuit, times R2. Okay, and so then that tells us then that we have that 6.944. How many fours did I put over there? Actually, I put too many fours up here. It should have been only two fours. That's 9.44 times 10 to the minus 4 amps times, in this case, is going to be the 4700 ohms. And so therefore then V2 is going to be equal to, and let's go ahead and calculate that out, that's going to be 6.944 times 10 raised to the negative fourth times 4700, and that's going to be a value of 3.264 volts for the voltage across number two. And then we have one more resistor left, one more resistor here, and that is voltage number three that we're looking for, the voltage across that. So that's V3 is equal to I, the current that's going through that is a total current, times our R3. And so that's going to be V3 then is equal to IT. Oops, pardon me. Let's go ahead and put the value in. So that's 6.944 times 10 to the minus fourth times 1000. All right. So V3 then is going to equal to what? It sounds like 0.69. But let's go ahead and calculate it out. Just 6.944 times 10 raised to the negative fourth, and that's going to be multiplied by 1000, and that is 0.6944 volts as the voltage across R3. All right, so we found the voltage across R3, the voltage across R2, the voltage across R1, and we found our total current for this series circuit. So that's the theoretical values that we just calculated for all three for this given circuit.